I got another banger for you guys. Stay tuned. Guys, welcome to the Mr. Bubble channel, where we dish out awesome pressure washing business advice to beginners. And in today's episode, we're going to be talking about all the different ways that you can grow your pressure washing business in 2024. So let's go ahead and jump right in. I actually got five things on this for you guys. Number one, we're going to be talking about target marketing. Guys, in 2024, if you want to grow your pressure washing business, you need to make sure that you guys are doing target marketing. Now, there's a lot of different things to cover here. So what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm actually going to make a separate video on the topic of target marketing. I'm going to give you guys like 10 great ideas on how you can target market for your pressure washing business. But for the sake of today's video, we're going to talk specifically about boots on the ground marketing and how you're going to use the 6x9s to target marketing. Now, I know you can't see those really well on camera, so I put up the design here for you guys. This is what it looks like on the front. Very important for you to have that box right there, guys. You see that box? One of your neighbors just got a Mr. Bubbles house wash. It creates sales impulse. And when we're talking about impulse, your four factors of impulse, the most important one being the greed factor, keeping up with the Joneses. So make sure that you guys have that on your designs. And like I've said this many times, guys, I'll send you this design and you can just copy it. I always tell you guys, make sure that you copy success, right? Okay, so target marketing, guys. So when we're talking about target marketing specifically with your 6x9s, what I'm talking about is you guys are going to target market neighborhoods, affluent neighborhoods. And so we're talking about like houses that are in that $400,000 to $600,000 range. Man, I want you guys being like laser guided missiles to those neighborhoods, and you're literally going to drive around looking for dirty homes. And I'm going to give you guys a great tip here. Great tip. So you go on Google and you find out, you put on there HOA neighborhoods in whatever county. In my case here, I'm in Charles County. So a few years back, I did this and I actually found a PDF. Okay, a PDF. I have it saved on my computer with the list of all the HOA neighborhoods in my area. And this PDF, guess what, guys? It had their phone number. It had like their email that I could contact. And so what I did is I actually target marketed those specific neighborhoods, right? Because they're the ones, guys, that are sending out those crazy letters to people. And a lot of people in those neighborhoods are gonna want to get service, pressure washing done in their homes. So when you're driving around those nice neighborhoods, those HOA type neighborhoods, as you are target marketing, guys, it's real simple. You want to look for dirty homes. Of course, these things are gonna stand out, guys. Like, actually, they're gonna stand out like a green thumb because they're literally green and black all over the house. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your 6x9, you're gonna walk up to the door and leave it there in the jamb of the door, or you simply, you fold it like this and then you put it in between the doorknob. Guys, do not, I repeat, do not put these in a mailbox, because that is illegal to do that in every state throughout the country. It's illegal to do that. So just leave it on the door. You don't need to knock. You don't need to do a sales pitch at this time. And here's the goal, guys. I'm going to challenge you on this. So you want to be doing about 1,000 homes a month, where you're literally targeting your ideal customer. You see what I'm saying? You see where I'm going with this? Guys, in 2024, okay, if you want to make a lot of money in the pressure washing business, you need to make sure that you are target marketing your ideal customer, because these are the type of customers that are going to help you grow your business, right? It's a lot of you guys are doing the easy thing. So you go to social media marketing because it doesn't require a lot of effort. But guess what? everybody else, including your competitors, are doing the easy thing. You guys need to get out there, get your name out there, get your face in front of people, your smile, and shake some hands, and make sure you guys are doing target marketing, because it's really going to differentiate you from your competition. Number two on our list, guys, something we talk a lot about on the Mr. Bubbles channel is Google My Business. Guys, you will not be able to run a successful pressure washing business in 2024 without an optimized Google My Business, SEO, right? Search engine optimization. Now, the good news is I have already done a video on this exact topic. If you have not seen that video, search it out in my library. It's episode 56. 56, guys. Go ahead and watch that right after you watch this one. Take a bunch of notes and simply apply, because guess what? That video is a step-by-step tutorial. It's covering things like eminent domain backlinks, map citations, keywords research, and all of that good stuff. So again, just go ahead and watch that. But I'm gonna share you guys with you guys a tip, because this is something I just came up with about a week ago, so I have not yet talked about this on camera. So something that we're doing in 2024 that is brand new that I wanna see you guys do as well. So what we did is we printed out like the QR code of our Google My Business. In order to get a QR code, just Google that. There's a bunch of websites. You print it out. So we printed this out actually at Staples in like really, really thick card, like a really thick stock card. And then so printed it on both sides, and then we cut it out and had it laminated. And we put these on lanyards on all of our trucks. The reason why we did this is because of this. So now whenever we're at a house, and you know, they're excited, they want to leave a review, boom, here it is, scan it, leave you a review right then and there. Because guys, come on, this, to all of us, this has happened where customer was really excited and happy, they said that they were going to leave a review, but they never did. So this year, I'm Mr. Bubbles, we have close to 400 five-star reviews, but we're trying to get to, our goal is to get to 600 this year, and this is what we're doing to be able to push those five-star reviews. So that's a great tip for you guys. It's going to help you a lot to get those reviews. So obviously, when you're talking about Google My Business, your reviews is also going to play a big part in that. But guys, make sure that you watch that video, episode 56, and do everything on there, because it's really, really going to help you rank high in your area. Okay. Number three on our list. Wow. What can I say about this? Networking. Guys, something that we, man, it is like almost in every video, I'm basically talking about networking. And the reason why I talk about networking so much, guys, is because it's effective. And I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of inside baseball, okay? So when I was in year 4, 5, and 6, I got stuck. And what it was I had reached this sort of like a sales limit, like a money limit. I just hit this sort of glass ceiling for my business. And no matter what I did, I just could not get over that hump, right? And I tried everything, guys. At that time, I remember, for example, I was big on Yelp. I did a lot of Yelp ads, but I was running Yelp, Google ads, and Facebook ads. And between the three, I was spending $5,000 a month. But guess what? Not even that helped. So eventually, right around year 7, I said to myself, you know what? I spent a lot of money in these digital formats, a lot of money in all kinds of different marketing. And then finally, in that year, I started to research it real good, bought a book, and that book talked a lot about the power of marketing. So that's when I started to do marketing. And then in year 8 and 9, man, my business, guys, just took off like a rocket ship. Because this is what happens with networking. Networking is very important, because so here's the deal. Consumers want to do business with people they know, they trust, and they like. And so in order for you to build that in your marketplace, you're going to have to do a lot of networking. You're going to have to get out there and just get your name out there. and build relationships with people, other entrepreneurs, but also other people even in the same exact industry. Guys, the bottom line is you just need to get out there, build a huge portfolio of people. One of the ways that we do networking is we reach out to companies. Like I'm not a roofer, for example. That's a great example. So I send work to roofers, roofers send work to me. Another example, house flippers, builders. We have about 20, 30 builders that constantly send us work, and we're always on the lookout to send work to them as well. Guys, networking will take you to the next level, but here's the deal. The reason why a lot of people don't do networking is because there's no instant gratification in it, right? You don't see the results of it right away. It's going to take a while, maybe 1 year or more. But I promise you guys, you know, if I'm bringing it to you, it's because it's been lab tested and I know that it works and I know that it's going to make a difference in your life and your business. So make sure that you guys are doing network. What I recommend is the very first group that you should join should be your local chamber of commerce. They're going to do tons and tons of events that you can go to, and it's really going to elevate your game. Enough said about that, guys. Make sure that you're jumping into the networking game. Next, something else we talk a lot about, making sure that your pricing is right. The number one mistake that new guys make, as a matter of fact, when they're starting out in a pressure washing business, is that their pricing is all goofed up. Right? Like sometimes they're charging $400-$500 for one job in the same neighborhood. Then they're doing the next day or a week later, they're doing the same type of job, same neighborhood, but for $200. So there's no rhyme or reason to it. Guys, make sure that you're going out there and you're charging like a professional. You're charging accordingly, because things are expensive, guys. Like, and we're talking about how to grow your business, your pressure washing business in 2024. How are you going to grow your business if your pricing is not right? You need to buy hoses. You need to upgrade your equipment. You need truck wraps. You need to wrap your vehicle. We've talked about all of these things. Well, guess what? None of those things are going to matter if your pricing is not right. That has to be really the foundation, one of the cores of your business, getting your pricing right. Now, of course, you guys already know this. Some of you guys have already emailed me. I will email you a two-page PDF. It literally has all the price points in the industry of like all your major services. It's our pricing guideline for 2024. Guys, make sure you email me. You can find my email in the description below. I tell you guys this all the time. Ask@MrBubbles.com. Ask@MrBubbles.com. Email me. I'll email you this, this two-page PDF. Print that out. Make sure you print it out and you laminate it. Keep it in your truck as a reference, because this is going to give you pricing on soft washing, roof cleaning. A lot of you guys reach out to me for gutter cleaning prices. That's going to give you exactly what you need to charge for gutter cleaning as well. Guys, make sure that you become knowledgeable in this area, because if you do not get this right, man, I mean, the chances of you making it is very slim if you don't get your pricing right, guys. That's why I'm always shedding a lot of light in this, because I want to see you guys make money, okay? So number five on my list, the last thing on this list for today, make sure that you guys are focusing on branding. So here's the thing. Marketing is what you do to get a customer, right? And branding is what you do to build a reputation in your marketplace. You see the difference between the two? So I'll give an example. Marketing, like doing yard signs is a great example. You go out there and you put out some yard signs, that's marketing. That's what you're physically doing to be able to get clients, right? So that's marketing. Branding is something that is a lot more, like it requires a lot more of your time. It requires a lot more effort as well. And this is something, by the way, that's why I mentioned like networking and target marketing. We always talk about these things because all of these things flow together with branding. Now, I know a lot of you guys, when you hear the word branding, your mind automatically jumps to like, oh, I need to make sure that I have a logo and my website looks good and I have online presence. Guys, all of those things are important. And by the way, branding is such a huge thing that I'm going to do a separate video on this, and I'm going to do like a top 10 ways that you can brand your company, right? But for the purpose of today's video, we're going to talk specifically about this, how customer service affects your brand. Guys, So I did an episode, man, for the life of me, I can't remember. You know what? I'll put up here for you guys what episode this was that I did. I'll put up the thumbnail so you guys can search this out. So anyway, I talked about customer service, but I'm going to give you the Cliff Notes version right now. You need to make sure you're doing these four things right if you want to grow your brand when it comes to customer service, because that's a big part of branding. You want to make sure you answer your phone, show up on time, be friendly and polite, and finally do quality work. You will not be able to build a very solid reputation in your marketplace if you're not doing those things right. Let me repeat them. You want to answer the phone, because a lot of your competitors, actually some of you guys that are listening to me right now are not picking up your phone. Need to make sure you pick up your phone. Need to make sure that you show up on time when you're supposed to be there. And then you need to make sure 100% that you're doing these things no matter what. And then obviously quality work, guys. Oh, and I forgot to mention that one of the most important. Guys, just be polite to people. Be friendly. And then what I was saying about the quality work, you can do all of those things right, but if the work is terrible, then what does it matter? Then you're going to cause the opposite. You're going to cause negative branding. People are going to spread the word on Facebook and things like that on how horrible your services are and how rude you are and blah, blah, blah. And you're going to absolutely destroy your reputation in the marketplace. The same can be said, like, for example, if you're going out there and you're killing people's plants and you're destroying their house, obviously that's going to kill your reputation in the marketplace. So, guys, make sure that you're 100% focused, okay? Okay? If you want to make a lot of money in a pressure washing business in 2024, it's all about the brand. It's all about growing your brand. Meaning, it's all about building your reputation in the marketplace. Make sure that you're 100% focused on your brand. And that's all I got for you guys today. I really, really appreciate you coming to my channel and watching this how to grow your pressure washing business in 2024 video. Guys, I highly recommend you watch the next episode as well. In the very next episode, we're going to be going back out in the field and we're doing some good old-fashioned house washing. I know you guys absolutely love watching me out there knocking down some of these jobs. And and I mentioned this earlier, make sure you email me. Guys, I answer all of my email. Let me send you this pricing blueprint so you guys are not goofing that up. And that's going to help you out a lot in your business. And you guys know this because I interact with a lot of you guys. Look, guys, here's the bottom line. We are building an amazing, amazing community here on YouTube, like a tribe. And you guys are part of that network. You guys are part of my network. And you guys, I am part. You guys are also part of my network. You see what I'm saying? The synergy there, guys. We're a part of each other's network. I mean, how many of you guys that I've already sent you the marketing blueprint, pricing blueprint, the trailer build blueprint? And you see how that works, guys? When you network with people, it brings value to your life, just like you guys bring a lot of value to my life. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Bubbles out.